Welcome to the last round, round three, as we play for a potential 3-0 if we win. Our opponent is on the play, kept seven, and we're going to mulligan this, just one land. I'm going to keep this, I'm not thrilled, but a six card hand, if I have spells and lands, I'm going to keep. Alright, no two drop, that's what I'd like to see. Clean sleeve artisan. I'm gonna play this guy. Make it a 1/4. Great. My 1/4 is looking pretty good right now. I'm gonna play this. Get our red. And look who showed up. Ambitious. Thing. Okay. So he's no brainer, just making a ton of servos. I would think that he has an inspired charge. I have to think that. Like, this would be a lot better as a 5/4 because it gets through that and that. I mean, I could double block, but he would. I guess I would. It wouldn't be as good. So yeah, maybe it would still make a servo without having inspired charge. In any case, I think playing Aviator. Aviator is a good card to beat Inspired Charge. Ninth Bridge Patrol. Master Trinketeer. That's a card. Well, it's gonna get Welding Sparks probably later, but for now, let's block. Don't really have that many good blocks. Also, this is gonna become a problem. So let's say this, or. This, and I could double block the Clint Sleeve Artisan. This becomes a 3/3. Yeah, that's fine. I could save something at Armin Courage. I could save my 3/2. Is that even good? Well, it could save my 2 Thopters as well. It saves my 2 Thopters because. Obviously I pumped the one that he put first, and he has to deal enough damage to the first one. Keeping my Wild Wanderer would mean being able to block this, because this is going to be a 3/3 now. Okay, I guess a 4/4 because this is going to die to my Welding Sparks. I feel like nothing is worth keeping. I think I keep Wild Water. Okay, we'll play Theorist. And I could even let him attack with everything and then combat Welding Sparks, but it's a little bit risky if he has a removal. If he has like a protection such as Chromatic Maneuver, he could have could have... Well, you could make a servo and get some sort of value, although I wouldn't mind so much. You could have rush, vitality, you could have something to pump it. Yeah, I think it's a little bit risky. We're just going to kill it now. Well, I guess that wouldn't be too... It wouldn't be that bad if he was trying to protect it and everything, because as soon as I draw my seventh land, I'm probably just gonna bounce the board and not care about all these tokens. Okay, attacks for three. I have a reach blocker. What else? Familiar, okay. No attacks. I should have scryed maybe upkeep to try and get my seventh land. But I didn't have a stop set up, so I didn't think about it. Or thought about it too late. Okay. Wow, this highest priority isn't doing work. It's overtime. Although I'm saying that I want to draw a land, but I also don't want it. I don't mind drawing any of the spells that I can, any all of the spells I can draw. I don't mind. So, yeah, I'm not scrying. There we go. Big Daddy. I think I might just win almost every. I think I might have won like every single game with it or something. Okay. That's weird. Does that mean inspire charge? Let's go to blocks. This. This goes there. This goes there. This goes there. If this is inspired charge, it is not bad for me. Not really bad for me at all. Might also just want to get a bunch of counters on this 9th bridge patrol. Combative maneuver. Okay. Pump the familiar. Okay, I guess I lose my aviator. Could be worse. Now, I do not want to draw land, so I will scry with Theorist. Mechanic. Let's bounce like Herald of the Fair, probably. So he has a gigantic patrol. I'm gonna have to chump it for a while. Yeah, bounce to Herald. 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 Bottom. No need to scry an upkeep. It's not necessary, we're not that much in a rush. Can bash for 6. I'm at 18. Yeah. Yeah, let's kill that guy. Now probably won't scry so that I have exactly 8 energy. Okay. ounce to board, I think. Yeah. Sure, get a bunch of triggers. Play that. Play Wild Wanderer. Yes, we'll get a Fort Island. Attack for 6. Familiar. Screecher. I could scry. Probably unnecessary. Attack with this. Play this guy as a 1/4 pass. Plays mechanic. That's fine. Okay. He has one more turn, I guess, by doing that. Still a scry end of turn. Cry as well. But I all opt for scrying instead of crying. Appetite. Do I even want that? Not really. Okay, play this. Voyager. Okay. We'll bounce the board. Because it's fun. Attack for 6. Down to 2. We have a new flyer in our hand. And 6 more mana. So these 2. And a wanderer. No module, this game is a little bit disappointing, but the other Squall Ancient got there again. Now I think I should scry. So I guess if I draw anything that makes 2 energy, I win. If I scry, I need to find something that makes 3, and it's less likely. I guess we will not scry. Okay, there we go. Six damage. All right. So, Could board and puzzle knot, considering it kills creature and like some of the tokens and stuff like that. If there's a deck where it's good against, it's definitely this one. We didn't see that much for appetite, but it's kind of it feels safe to just keep it for a vehicle or some sort, and it also kills revoke and whatnot. In a worst case, it's gonna kill a servo or something. So yeah, kind of like just keeping this deck as is again. We never really drew turtle in the early turns, so it's hard to tell if I would want to board it out. although it's probably okay against his deck. And unlike Puzzle Knot, actually is more synergic with our deck since it makes energy. So I'm just gonna keep this as is again. If I was like an artifact deck, I would want to board in this Puzzle Knot a lot more, since it would actually synergize with our deck. But we have to cut a synergic card to play it, so I don't want that. All right, I'm keeping. All right. I'll pass here. Okay, so your construct. So we'll probably not play Cub since it's going to be contested. We want that. Yep. And I'll play. Play Turtle. I could play Turtle here. Attuning to Turtle. Or I could play Servant. By playing Servant, I don't really like playing Servant because I don't want to trade. So I actually like Attune into Turtle. I guess I could have played Cub too. Considering I have Attune and Turtle, it makes energy and Servant, it's really easy to just make it out of range of something and just attack. Yeah, it might have been my best line actually. Courage. So I can play Cub, which is gonna be a 4/4. And then like keep Courage up. Yeah, I like that. Yeah, one thing I dislike about this module is 3 mana, I have to take a turn off to play it. So annoying. Okay. Well, I'm gonna block. Because I have Courage, I'm not too scared of tricks. Yep, yep. Num num num. Okay, nothing else. Black Puzzle Knot, okay. Mechanic, bounce the Puzzle Knot. Good stuff. Okay, so I will attack with the Cub. If he double blocks, I can Courage. If he does not, I can just play Module and pass. He's probably gonna double block. Nope. Okay. Play Module or Era plus something. I'll just play Module. Could have Tidy Conclusion on the Cub there. Nope, I'm gonna just replace the Puzzle Knot. Familiar, okay. Attacks with nothing. So I'll play Servant. Counter on Servant, or just go all in on Cub, maybe. I like maybe just Turtle. And I attack with it, yeah. No blocks. Wow. Do I put a counter on the Cub? I think so. turtle. Actually, I should have put a counter on the servant. So I have a 3-3 of blocks. Here's a goggles. Inventor's goggles. All of these games have been extremely, I would not say easy, because some of them obviously could have lost, but I think our deck was good. Definitely good. I would say it was solid, like you go 2-1 with that deck. I think we've definitely played against a bunch of underpowered decks too. So I can Ornament of Courage something and kill a creature and trade with the servant, although having the mana is not horrible. With that mana up, there's not much you can do to our blockers. So probably Ornamental Courage like this. So the reason I don't do it on my servant is that because he could have Essence Extraction, I guess. It doesn't really matter. I don't know if I even want to trade with the servant. Definitely block this. Or I guess this is better, because it's an artifact. And this. Do I trade with mechanic or not? Having access to mana is probably good. Pioneer, okay. Decoction module. Could play it. Next turn, play High Spire Artisan. We'll start by attacking. Yes, a chump. Servo. It's probably safer to play Icespire Artisan this turn and playing module. Like, it is better card advantage wise to play. Like, we'll get more things out of it, like, of playing module first, but, especially with, like, the other module, just, it's basically going off. However, we're already ahead, and I think we could only lose if we're getting raced, or, like, just dealt a bunch of damage out of nowhere, and this is, playing this could lead to that, so. Just gonna keep on playing my cards here. Ion Curve cards instead of trying to be greedy and have fun. So then we're gonna have fun by winning some packs. Okay, attacks with everything. Block this and this. It's gonna play Inspired Charge, and that is not gonna do. It's not gonna do anything. So you would just die. Combatic maneuver. Okay. You got one more turn. Fragmentize, okay. Alright, we drill land. We'll keep on attacking with these two. Do not have energy to make it lethal. So he can go to one life. Well, that means he can't crack his puzzle nut. Play this and this. Pillar bug. Okay. No attacks, no cards in hand. I can play. So I attack with cub and turtle. He puts the familiar on the turtle, and the cub is double blocked. So I guess I have to attack with the Spire Artisan if I want to do that. In which case, he would go Pioneer. No, he gains two life with that, so he could still make that block and survive. Because I don't really have a good attack there. So I just do nothing. Yeah, I actually like doing nothing. The reason is, okay, so I don't let him gain life with that, so I don't give him an extra card with that, and I don't give him an extra card with that. And if I just draw lands and this game drags on, I'm just gonna win, because my hand is insane. And so is my board. Like to scry. And he scryed on top, we're gonna scry on top as well. Okay. I can decoction module turtle. It's not really going to do much. Just play aviator here. Get a million triggers. I don't have mana. No. 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 Could attack with cub and or turtle. I'm not gonna do it for same reasons as earlier. Just gonna hopefully get those topthers in there. He has to attack with pillar bug here, which is super bad for him. Malfunction the familiar, no, the pioneer, and my cub and my turtle have to be blocked. Doesn't really have good blocks. He can chump with familiar and servo, take three. Yeah, it's not that great, so I'll just do that. Interesting. This goes there. Don't want it to die. This goes there, there, there. Does he have Fumigate? Does he have Fumigate? Okay. Nope. That's not Fumigate. Alright, we win. Great. Well, that was a 3-0. That was also
basically a sweep. In any case, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next week for another video.